Hey guys, so before we begin, I just wanted to remind you that my upcoming short film, The Haunting Dreams of a Distraught Widow, is now funding. There's a campaign on Indiegogo, it's ongoing, it's gonna stop by the end of October on the 31st. This is a big passion project of mine, a mixture of Lynch and Lars von Trier, and surrealism and horror and drama. So if you guys are interested in supporting me and supporting this short film that I'm working on, please follow the link in the description below to fund The Haunting Dreams of a Distraught Widow on Indiegogo. Thank you for your support. And now, back to the video. Trouble Every Day is a 2001 French arthouse horror film written and directed by Claire Denis and starring Vincent Gallo, Trisha Vessi, Béatrice Dalle and Alex Descartes. And Claire Denis is a really, really fascinating filmmaker. She's been working for many, many years now, making some of the most fascinating and ambiguous and provoking films of recent memory. Claire Denis, I wasn't a big fan of at first, I'll be completely honest. Of the four films that I saw of her last year, the only one I really, really liked was Beau Travail, her masterpiece. But more recently, I started diving deep into her filmography again. And one of the films that I decided to rewatch that I saw last year, but I wanted to rewatch it and rediscover it, give it another shot, was Trouble Every Day. And I have to say, I really dug it this time around. Trouble Every Day, more so than any other film in Denis's filmography, is super ambiguous. The plot itself is paper thin. This film is like 90-100 minutes long, and it is about a newlywed couple of Americans going to Paris for their honeymoon, supposedly so, but actually the husband in this relationship, played by Vincent Gallo, is looking for an old flame. An old flame played by Béatrice Dalle, who is now married to a doctor. And this old flame is having some problems that involve having sex with a lot of different men, and after having sex with them, eating them up and murdering them. So this premise probably is like, you're probably building something in your mind of what type of film this is going to be. It's not that type of film. There is gore in this film, there is some violence, there is a lot of eroticism to it, but it's not a straightforward watch. There's barely any dialogue in this, barely anything is explained to you. A lot of key parts of the plot, just like with other Claire Denis films, they are omitted. There's a lot of fragmented narrative going on where you don't really know what's going on, but also by not showing something, you kind of understand what's happening. It's incredibly fascinating. It's something that definitely is not for the mainstream, not something that's easily accessible. And I at first didn't like it. When I first saw it, I was not a fan of this. I found it to be slow, dull, boring. And now it is very slow, but the slowness and the quietness of it all has become its main selling point for me, its main driving force. These people are not talking to one another, they're not being honest with themselves and with the others. There's a lot of unrequited emotions going on, a lot of animalistic violence, animalistic feelings, all of this sexuality mixed with blood and violence. It's an incredibly primal film. And Denis has always been fascinating with those elements, with those themes, but they're really prevalent in this film. And it wouldn't work if not only with the stellar camera work and the very atmospheric music by Tindersticks, but also by Denis' direction, by having very nuanced, very subtle performances. All four of the main actors do a fantastic job in this. They don't shy away from a lot of grotesque parts, and from not talking a lot. That's one of the main problems, even as a director. A lot of actors want to show you how good they are at delivering monologues and doing a lot of powerful emotions, but the hardest ones to capture are the more subtle ones. The sadness in someone's eyes, the longing for something. And all four of them do a great job in this one, absolutely great. And the way this escalates constantly until it ends in a bonkers climax that, for horror convention, is incredibly downplayed and almost underwhelming in a way, but for the type of film that this is, it actually hits you like a freight train. It's like, bam, powerful, strong. So honestly, in the amount of horror, I highly recommend you watch something different, something unique, something you probably don't even know existed before now. Trouble Every Day by Claire Denis. I highly recommend this one, especially if you like arthouse films, horror films. The closer comparison I can make is probably Raw. I can see that being very inspired by this film. But still, if you guys watch Trouble Every Day, and which is your favorite Claire Denis film, tell me in the comments below. Thank you guys for watching. To like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.